If you want to write a fiction book in English or in any other language, you have a very simple, almost a perfect platform to do that today. It's called NovelCrafter. So today I'm going to, in this quick video, in about 10 minutes, I will explain everything you need to know in order to start writing the book on NovelCrafter. As always, you have the link in the description below. You're also invited to subscribe to my channel, which I teach how to create and write books, scripts, and films using AI. So let's dive in. This is NovelCrafter. This is the link. You can find it below. It gives a 14 days free trial. And my first tip is plan your book well before you start the system, so you could know your characters, your plot, and you could use more effectively the 14 days trial. And even write the book in 14 days. I did it in 7 days. So you get into the system. This is the infrastructures. These are the novels. These are the series tab, which is, I don't have a series, but the first thing you need to do is go into here, into under your account, to open settings, and you need to connect your OpenAI key and OpenRouter key. I don't go into details to doing that, but you will need to get the OpenAI key and the OpenRouter key in order to use the different models. The next phase is open the novels or start the novel. You write create novel. This is a demonstration book. You need to first click this tab, and this is the metadata. Here you write the name of the novel, your name as the author. If it's a part of a series, you can add a cover if you want. This is really important, pressing the writing, and you need to define what's the style. If it's a past or present, what language, and you have many languages you could choose from. You have like many languages you could choose from. You could find your language, but I suggest you to write first in English to practice the system. You could decide if it's first person or it's a third person, or if one of your characters telling the stories, you could choose to collaborate with someone, and in the end you could export your book in that tab. Now let's see how you need a book. The first thing you need after you've defined your book is to write the codex. The codex is your database, the book database. This is the way that the AI knows what happens. So in the codex, you could see you have like a description of each one of the characters. Let's take, for example, my protagonist, which is Jacob. So we could see we could define him as a protagonist. We could give a description of his characters and describe in any one of the characters. So the system, NovelCrafter system, will know what happened. You could also elaborate on the world of the book, objects, lore, the genre that you write about. This is the data set that actually the AI know how to write. The next thing is to plan your book. As you see, this is the main tab. So we're gonna navigate through here. Let's see an example of the first book, which is more of an example. So when you press the plan, you have an option to plan the book. So in the lower, you could see create from outline. You have a few structures that anyone that knows how to write the stories know these structures, and you could use them in order to help writing plan your book. But I strongly recommend for you to plan your book ahead and come prepare to the system and knows how the plot goes. Let's go to a more elaborated book. So here you could see that I already wrote the scene synopsis. In each scene, you could know what is happening. You could see the system knows what characters are in each scene. So you could add a new chapter, and in each chapter you could add a few scenes. For instance, this year I have only one scene in this opening chapter, but then in the next chapter you could see I have three scenes. So this is the way that I planned the entire book. Now let's see writing a scene in practice. Let's go to a place that I haven't written yet before. For instance, chapter 9. Oh, it's a bit written. Okay, let's say I want to write something. I open a new line. First of all, I can just write, you know, it's like writing in words. So if you want to just write something, you could do that straight out of the box here. But the other option, which is more interesting, is often you open and then you, it's like a bit like a Midjourney. You put a cursor and then you write scene beat. In the scene beat, you write like a synopsis of what you want. It's like, in essence, what you want to happen in the scene. So here I'm copying from the beat and I'm just saying that I want you to write you know, the scene about the three brothers that courting Rachel. Then you write generate prose and it gives you a system. And then this is why it is important that we connected the OpenAI key and the OpenRouter key, because you have here like a few options of the model. Actually, you have all the models. You could have OpenAI models and Claude models. As you can see, these are all moderated models. So sometimes if you explicit scenes or a violent scene, they could refuse to write them. But let's say I want ChatGPT open. Oh, this is a good example. The model of ChatGPT doesn't want to write the scene. I don't know exactly why. Maybe it's because of violence. So let's try a different model. Let's try Claude, for instance. So let's see if you will agree to write this scene. And it starts writing. As you can see, he starts writing. So it's going to take him a few times. You could apply, you could try, saying you could try the scene, or you could describe, just erase everything. You can also try to, he's still writing, so I'll show you in a minute. For instance, just note it on the side that you could see the word count running, and it could also, it could almost run like 900 words in one run. So you need to read this. It's not like set and forget. You need to see what he's writing. So let's say we apply. As you could see, I can choose each one of the sentences or the paragraph, and I can rephrase it. And I can choose another model to rephrase it. I can expand. I can shorten. I can also copy this to a snippet. Snippet is a good way of remembering things that I want. For instance, I just made a note for the end of the book, so I want to remember that. So everything that I want, I can save in the snippet. I could also add things to the codex. So let's try another model, for instance, Gemini Pro, which is like a new addition to this system. And let's see how Gemini write the same scene. So in practice, what I usually do is like give two models or three models sometime to write a certain scene and then combine all what they did in order to make the chapter or the scene that I want, what is best for me. My full recommendation is you need to go to action and you need to summarize the scene. And you need to, after you finish the chapter, because sometimes you write things that you didn't plan, and you need to summarize the scene so in order for the system to remember what happened in each one of the scenes. So let's see a few things. In reviews, for instance, you could see the total word count. You see also number of words, word count in each scene, and also in chapter. Also, chat is an interesting feature that you need to see. It adds a bit of money, but you could ask certain questions to the chat. For instance, I asked him what herbs can help a man when he's hydrated in the desert, and it was helpful. Now again, I don't use it because I also pay for ChatGPT, so I don't pay the $6 extra for using the chat. But if you don't use other, this is also a very useful feature. This is how the NovelCrafter system work, and you could join today using the link below, get your 14-day trial and start writing your book. But it is for me, it's very important to make it clear that if you go into the platform and you start writing without planning, without knowing what's your plot, what's your character, what's the story is about, then you won't get a good book. So it is important to say that AI is a good tool, but it's still a tool. We as human, as creators, need to direct it, need to teach it and tell it what to do. So we need to know what our story is about. And if we know that, then we could use that platform, NovelCrafter, which is a great tool to write our next book. So I hope you find this tutorial helpful and use it to write good books. If you have any questions, please add them in the comments below, and I could add more tutorials showing maybe things, how to solve things that you encounter in the NovelCrafter system. Good luck!